Hi, my name is Mark Friend, and I am a director here at Friend & Grant, and also a registered auditor. It's a common misconception that all companies need an audit. Firstly, an audit is an examination of the financial statements of an organisation by someone independent of that organisation. Financial statements include a balance sheet, an income statement, a statement of changes in equity, a cash flow statement, and notes comprising a summary of significant accounting policies and other explanatory notes. The purpose of an audit is to form a view on whether the information presented in the financial statements, taken as a whole, reflects the financial position of the organisation at a given date. An audit is not confirmation that every transaction is correct. As an auditor, we sample test transactions and ultimately write a report confirming that we have carried out sufficient work to say whether or not the financial statements are materially misstated. Material misstatement is based on what, as an auditor, we determine materiality is. For a company with, say, a turnover of £100 million, materiality could be based on turnover and set at 1% of £1 million. An error of £100,000 would therefore be considered immaterial. As an accountant, we prepare the financial statements from the accounting records, and as such, we still have a professional responsibility to ensure that we do not put our names to anything which we know to be wrong. We will carry out many of the tests an auditor would carry out, but ultimately, we do not need to carry out a formal examination of the accounts. So who needs legally an audit? For financial years that begin on or after the 1st of January 2016, a company will require an audit if it exceeds at least two of the following. Firstly, the annual turnover is no more than £10.2 million. Secondly, assets worth no more than £5.1 million. And finally, 50 or fewer employees on average. The rules for charities are different. An audit will be needed if total assets before liabilities exceeds £3.26 million and turnover exceeds £250,000, or if the charity's gross income is more than £1 million. So, in general, small companies do not require an audit unless they want one. I am both an accountant and a registered auditor, so if you do require an audit, then please call me if you require further information.